Hi friends, welcome to this class. I am your Karthik Ravindra Katya and this is Katya Tutorials, right? So in this video, I am going to discuss about this geometry, shape and hybridization, right? So some people get confused between geometry and shape, right? Both things are different. As I give you the examples and everything, you will get to know. So in this videos, we are going to discuss about the geometry, shape and hybridization of CLF3, VRF5 and IF7, right? So these are all these chlorine, bromine, iodine are halogen family, right? So before giving the structure everything, let us see few points, right? So if you see the periodic table, so let me draw here. So this is our helium, neon, argon, krypton and xenon. Let us wind up here only. So it is 2 atomic number, 2, 10, 18, 36, 54, right? So this is the atomic number. So here we will get fluorine next, before fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine here, right? So this is the thing. So periodic table will be, it contains 6 p elements like this. It will be having 6 groups, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this will be 5th and this will be 6th, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5th will be halogens will be 5th period, yes, or 5th group, and 6th one will be the noble gas, right? So this is halogen period group, I can call halogen, and this one is noble gas period, sorry, group. These are groups, right? This vertical columns are called as groups, right? So horizontally we have, this is first period, so this will be second, third, fourth and fifth, right? So why I am telling all those things, you will get to know as we move. And here we will be having d block elements. So here we will be having d block. How many? They will be 10. Like this, there will be 10 groups, and here I will be having S block elements, and it will be having 2 groups, hydrogen, helium. Next comes lithium, beryllium, boron. These are P block, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine and neon, right? So like this. So what we understood, so there will be 2 S period, right? So 2s, I can call simply s, and this center there will be d. They are totally 10, and p they are totally 6, right? And f they are totally 7, right? Means they f there will be totally 14, they will be 14, right? These s will be 2, d will be 10, p will be 6, and f will be 14, it is 14, right? So these are the basics. So these all you have learnt in periodic table. Why I wrote all those things? See, atomic number of, if you remember, atomic number of helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, this is the period. If you remember, you can remember 2 10 18 36 54, right? So you know, since neon atomic number is 10, what will be the atomic number of fluorine? It is previous to this neon, right? So it will be 9. So if you remember the atomic number of argon, it is 18, right? You can easily tell atomic number of chlorine will be 17. Don't get confused, I am writing it above, it doesn't mean it is atomic mass. I am telling by my tongue that it is atomic number only. I am telling only atomic number, I am not discussing about atomic mass here, right? So just I have space here, so I am writing here. Don't get confused, sir, why you are writing above, it is atomic mass. Don't get confused, right? As I have cleared it, right? And krypton, it is 36, then bromine will be 35, atomic number will be 35, and xenon it is 54, the iodine atomic number will be 53, right? So which you can check it with your periodic table, right? So iodine atomic number will be 53, bromine is 35, chlorine 17 and fluorine is what, 9, right? So you know that. So if see halina, sodium atomic number, it is after this neon, neon next sodium comes. So 10 plus 1 it is 11. Atomic number of sodium is 11. So if I want to tell the electronic configuration of sodium, electronic configuration of sodium. So initially you used to write it as 1s, 2s, 2p, 3s, right? So 11, right? So 1s, s can have 2 electron. So 2s, it can also have 2 electron. 3p, it can have 6 electron. So it is 2, 4 plus 6, it is 10 electron. But sodium is 11 electron. So 1 electron. You used to tell like that. Right, so sodium is nothing but 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. Right, but instead of telling like that, see, neon, its atomic number is 10. Now sodium atomic number was 11, right? So instead of writing all this 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, if you write the electronic configuration of neon, you will get same 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, right? Because 10 electron, 2, 4, 4 plus 6 is nothing but 10 electron. So instead of writing all the electronic configuration like that, you can write directly neon 3s1. It is the electronic configuration of sodium, right? So this is the shortcut method, right? So you can do that also, right? So neon 3s1, right? So let us now, since we are discussing the geometry, shape and hybridization of these things, let us write the electronic configuration of chlorine, bromine and iodine, right? So see, here sodium I got 3s1. Sodium next, what I will get? Magnesium I will get. So if you see magnesium, its atomic number is 12. If I write electronic configuration, it will be neon 3s2, right? So what it means, so I told s will have 2s, here it will be s1 and here it will be s2. So sodium is coming in first period, so it is having s1 in the valence electron. Since magnesium is coming in second group, so it will be having S2, so magnesium is having S2. What is this 3? 3 is nothing but period, which I have shown it. So this is first period, second period, third period, fourth period, fifth period, I told you, right? So sodium falls in 1, 2, 3, third period. So previously it has neon, so I wrote neon, next third period, so 3, yes, only first group, so S series it will form and it will have 1 only. And this magnesium, third period, so 3. Before to that it will be having neon, so neon, total electrons 12, right? Neon will be having 10 plus 2, 12. So it will be 2. Why it is 2? Because within the S it is falling in second group, right? So similarly, if I write for fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, so where they are falling? So they are falling, see, this is S1, this is S2. So here D1, D2, D2, like then D10 will be there. 1 to 10. So for P, it is P1, P2, P3, P4 and P5. Fluorine, it will be P5. Why it is P5? See, means for S, it will be having like this. So this is S. So one electron it can have, or it can, and also it can have two electrons, maximum of this two. Coming to P, its orbital will be like this. So 3, so it can have P1, P2, P3, P4, P5 and P6, right? So since chlorine, all these halogens are having P5, see, and it is the second period, fluorine is there in second. So before to that it has got helium, right? So can I write like this? Helium 2s2, because it will be having filled with these s orbital, and 2p5. So it is the electronic configuration of fluorine. What about chlorine? Before to that I have neon, so it will be neon, and it belongs to third period, 1, 2, 3, third period, so 3s2 3p5. Here no d orbital, so nothing will write, but here 3p next, 3d, d orbitals will be there. So can I write like this? 3d 0, I can write, because no electron, so I am writing it as 0, right? So now let us write the electronic configuration of these things. Chlorine next comes, bromine. So bromine means, here before to that I have argon, So electron configuration will be argon. Now it belongs to fourth period. So 4s2, 4p5, and 4d0. And next comes iodine. So it's argon. 5s2, 5p, sorry, 6. Right, 6p5 and 6d0. Right, let me check it once.
5s2, 5p5. Yes.
Sorry, what the mistake I did. So all this belongs to which period? This one is first period. First period is over. 2s2, 2p5. 3s2, 3p5. 4s2, 4p5. Correct. 5s2, 6 I wrote here. So it should be 5p5, 5d0. So these are the electronic configuration. So if you feel 5s2, 5p5, if you want to write like this, 5s2, you can write like this also. 5s2, 5p5. Instead of writing all this 5p5, you can write like this also. No problem. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Right. And some rules you know, whenever you want to fill 5 electrons, you have to fill like this. 1 here, next comes here, 3. 4 pairing happens with the opposite of spin inversion, and this is 5. Like this you should fill it, right? So these are few rules are there, Hoffa principle, Hund's principle, those rules I think you have studied in periodic table, right? So these are the electronic configurations, right? You should know. So once we know electronic configuration, then as soon as ligands comes, fluorines are nothing, I can call it as ligand also. As soon as this negative charge comes to these, some excitation happens, that those everything we shall see, right? Now what it is clear, you can write the electronic configuration of for all this fluorine, bromine, iodine, right? So this is clear to you, right? So I hope I made everything clear to you, right? So once you know this, all these things, let us see few more points, right? So let me give there are shortcut method without finding this hybridization everything. Let me tell it in this class only, right? So chlorine. So if you see, s orbital it is, and this will be d orbital, and this will be p orbital, and below we have f orbitals, right? So s there will be 2, d there will be 10, and for p it will be 6. 6 means 6 groups I am telling. Yes, two groups, one group, two group, right? So like this 6 group there will be for P, and 10 group for D, and 14 groups for F, right? And period maximum 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 will be the maximum periods, right? So these things you know, right? So here if you see valency, hydrogen comes here, right? And helium comes here, right? Valency will be like this. So here valency for this first period will be almost 1. For second period it will be 2, and coming to these p block elements, this will be 3 4 5 6 7 8 will be the valency maximum. Always valency increases from left to right, like this valency increases. So valency is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 and 8, right? So chlorine, all this see here, helium, next comes sodium, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, and neon, right? So these are second group. Next, helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon. So those things we won't bother. See, if you see valency for fluorine, it is 7. Means not only fluorine, all these halogens, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine, the valency is 7, right? So for oxygen, valency is 6, right? So these things you should know, right? So fluorine, valency will be 7, right? Bromine, valency is 7, iodine, valency is 7, right? For chlorine, let me take this chlorine. So chlorine also valency is 7. For chlorine, valency is 7, right? So one electron will write here, second electron, third electron, 4 5 6 7. Can I write it like this? So I pair two electrons, and totally four electrons, 2 and 4, 5, 6, 7, right? And fluorine, we know that fluorine means 7 valency, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. But fluorine doesn't form any, these lone pairs will remain as lone pairs only because its size is very small. It can't give, since it is more electronic, it will take. So fluorine will, let me show it by X like this. So these are valency of fluorine. Other things remains as paired only, lone pairs like this. Right, similarly here for fluorine. Other things remains as lone pairs here. That I am not going to show because I have shown it here. I hope you understood. So here, this one lone pair, this unpaired, these will form bonds like this. Right, for bromine, it will be 5 fluorine. You may ask, sir, why not 3 fluorine or why not 7 fluorine? That also I will tell. So fluorine means, so here if you see the fluorine valency, it will be 7 only, but bond formation if you see, it will form only one bond. So other things will remain as paired. So sometimes they will call this fluorine valency as 1 also, because only one electron will participate in bond formation, not other 6 electrons, right? So that way also you can remember, right? No problem. So it can have valency 1 or it can have valency 7, right? But fluorine will exhibit 1, chlorine will exhibit 3 valency, bromine will exhibit 5 valency, iodine will exhibit 7 valency, right? So it will be like 1, 3, 5, 7, because other things will be paired. For in case of chlorine, 2 lone pairs will be paired. In case of bromine, only one lone pair will be available, because it will form bond with 5 fluorine, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, only one will be available like this, right? Whereas chlorine it was 2, for bromine it is 1, for iodine no lone pair, all will make bond only, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7 fluorine it will make bond with, right? Like this they will make bond, no lone pair. But if you see on fluorine, in all the cases, it will be having 3 lone pair, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like this 6 electrons, 2, 4, 6 electrons, so 3 pairs, 1, 2, 3, here also 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, all fluorine will be having 3 lone pairs, right? So it is like fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, right? So bromine can, fluorine can form only one bond, and it can have 3 lone pairs. Lone pairs means these lone pairs, we call these as lone pairs because they have paired up, right? And chlorine can have 3 bond but 2 lone pair. If you count totally, 3 bond means there will be 3 electron, right? 3 electron. Lone pairs means they will be in pairs, so 2 into 2 4 5 6 7, so valency is 7, total valency. Here also if you see, 1 electron here, 3 into 2 6 plus 1 7, valency in all the cases valency is 7, but sometimes based on bond formation they will tell like that also, because it can only give this electron, they can tell it like that also. 5 bonds here, 1 lone pair. Here 7 bonds it can form, but 0 lone pair. It is 1 lone pair, 0 lone pair, like that, right? So we did the structure with that, right? So let us see the shape and geometry, that also we shall see now, right? I hope I got time to explain it all. Let me check my camera and then I will see. Yeah, I have got 10 more minutes, let me tell. So I told there is a shortcut method to tell the hybridization. So what is hybridization? Hybridization is nothing but count the number of sigma bonds plus lone pair of electron, right? This is hybridization. So here if you count sigma bond is single bond, is we call it as sigma bond. So 1, 2, 3 and number of lone pairs 1 and 2. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. For ClF3, it is 5. Hybridization is nothing but 5. Number of sigma bonds and number of lone pairs. For this BrF5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. It is 6. And for iodine, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It is 7. So whenever we know, 1 S can exist, 1 P, 1 D, right? So this is the thing. For 5, can I write like this? S, P, 3, totally 3P, 1S, 4 and 1D, sp3d. This is the hybridization, right? For 6, how can I write? 1s can be there, s, 3p can be there. Totally 3p means 3, 1s 4. I want 6, so 2 more, sp3d2. So this is the hybridization, right? And for 7, it will be 1s p3. Maximum p will be 3 only, no p4 p5, right? So maximum p is 3 and d3. Total, see, 3 plus 3 6 plus 1 7. Here 2 plus 3 5 plus 1 6. 1 plus 3 4, 4 plus 1 5. Right, so this is the hybridization. So for CLF3 hybridization is, sorry, CLF3 hybridization is sp3d. For BRF5 hybridization is sp3d2. For IF7 hybridization is sp3d3. Right, other things, how we got this hybridization, that all those things I will explain in one by one upcoming videos, right? No need to worry why we got only sp3d3 here, why we got sp3d, right? That I will explain it nicely, everything with clearly I will explain, right? So once we know hybridization, we can tell the shape, sorry, not shape, let us tell the geometry. Here we can call geometry. So for sp3d, it will be trigonal bipyramidal. For sp3d2, it is octahedral, so simply we can call it as OH, octahedral, right? For sp3d3, it will be like pentagonal bipyramidal, right? So this geometry, about shape and everything, when I discuss about these things, hybridization in detail, there I will tell its hybridization, geometry and shape in detail, that is in the upcoming videos, right? So this much you can remember, right? So what are the things? Hybridization shortcut method is nothing but count the number of sigma bonds and count the number of lone pairs. If it is 2, see here, if it is 2, then it will be sp. If it is 3, then it will be sp2. If it is 4, it is sp3. If it is 5, that is here, it will be sp3d. If it is 6, then it will be sp3d2. If it is 7, then it will be sp3d3, right? So you can count. So this is nothing but hybridization, I told, which involve number of sigma bonds plus number of lone pair of electron. So it is 2 sp, 1 plus 1 2, here 2 plus 1 3, 3 plus 1 4, 1 plus 3 4, 4 plus 1 5, like that. All these are shortcut method to find hybridization, right? Other things, how to tell the shape, those we shall see in the upcoming videos. Till then, take care and have a great day.